Barry Trotz, with his Stanley Cup, has been able to come in, been able to sell everybody his bag of goods.
The game tying goal!
Robin Lehner was sensational.
Scores! Matt Barzal with a hat trick! Rebound! They score! Devin Taves, a GWG.
A gutty effort by the Isles.
Bailey in front for Beauvillier. He scores! Valtteri Filppula.
And the New York Islanders win one for Barry Trotz and pull into first place in the Metropolitan Division.
Andrew Gross, they're the hottest team in the National Hockey League, and let's talk about these Islanders, starting by talking about just how different they are from this year as opposed to last year. What have been the keys to success for the turnaround this season?
Well, I think it starts with last season they give up 293 goals, which was not only the most in the NHL, it was the most in the league since 2007. And once Lou Lamoriello got hired and Barry Trotz got hired, they were both very, you know, emphatic about the fact that they thought the defense was going to be, in their words, a pretty easy fix, which sounded kind of crazy given it was pretty much going to be the same personnel coming back. And, you know, they had given up so many goals, but true to their word, they've implemented a really good defensive system. They've really taught these players positionally. You know, it's almost a kind of a simple system. I mean, the tenets are keep the other team to the outside, limit the rebounds, and you can see the results. Now they've given up the fewest goals in the NHL, and I think when you look to the turnaround, that's where it starts. It leads to everything. I mean, they're in games because of it. Their goaltending, obviously Thomas Greiss and Robin Lehner are both playing better than they did last season for different reasons. But, you know, they're also not having to make too many reads when the opponent's coming at them. It's a much simpler game for the goalies.
It's a remarkable turnaround. One of my favorite quotes that I've read this year was Barry Trotz talking to Matt Barzal. He said, when you have the puck, do what you do. When you don't have the puck, do what I tell you to do. It's working. Barzal is headed to his first All-Star game. What does that mean to the reigning Calder winner, the opportunity to represent his team and his division in the All-Star game?
Yeah, I think both Matt and the Islanders and Barry Trotz are sort of looking at it as the next step in Mathew Barzal's evolution here. Barry Trotz just talked about, you know, his advice to Barzal going out to San Jose, and that was really to take everything in and make this a learning experience. Really look at some of the other top players, how they interact not only with other players, how they interact with fans, how they prepare for things. And, you know, Mathew Barzal is 21. I mean, it's been a really good run for him in the NHL so far, winning the Calder Trophy last season, being an All-Star in his second year. But both he and Barry Trotz have talked about there's a long way to go. He's got elite talent, Barry Trotz says. Barry Trotz's job is to make him an elite player, and this is just another step in that process.
It has been a remarkable process of change, growth, and improvement for Robin Lehner. An amazing story, the fact that he has come back from the personal challenges. Then to play the way he's played in the crease, truly extraordinary. What has allowed this to happen?
Well, I mean, I think you start with Robin is obviously in a much better place in his life. I was talking to him after the Ducks win the other day, and he was just talking about, you know, the future was really bleak for him at points last season. You know, he was dealing with alcoholism, he had a pill addiction, he's been dealing with mental health issues. You know, now he's going on 10 months sober. He's under medication. You know, his mental health issues are under control, and he's in so much of a better place, and that kind of translates to his play. But beyond that, I mean, I don't think you can discount the work that Mitch Korn has done with him and Piero Greco. I mean, Robin was talking earlier in the season. He started a little slowly in his mind because to him, he was sort of relearning how to play the position in a little bit. He was talking about how weird it was for him to hold his arms at different angles than he was used to, and he was sort of thinking too much on the ice. I think now with the repetitive work he's done with Mitch Korn and Piero Greco, everything is feeling natural for him. You can't teach size, and he's just playing a very simple, economical game. As I started, a lot of the shots are coming from the outside. He's getting a lot of support, not a lot of rebounds, and he's, it just all adds up to him having, the truly remarkable seasons on the Islanders right now.
No doubt about it. Andrew Gross, thanks so much for joining us. Enjoy the game tonight.